Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Vinda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhu Bande Nitta Nanda Sahoditam Sri Nanda 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 Bande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopijana Samayuktam Bindavanam Manohar Vancha Kalpataru Vashyaki Pasindu Vyavacha Patitanam Pavane Bhavishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Mukam Karo Divachalam Pangum Langhaitigirim Yatki Patam Hangvandi Paramanandamadavam Vrindavi Tulsidevai Piyavai Keshavasar Shna Bhakti Pade Devi Sattvatvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Naranchaiva Narottamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasane Cha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Varunyo Deyam Sada Paribhavagna Mavishta Doham Tethas Padam Siva Virinchanutam Saranyam Beta Tiham Panatopal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charana Ravindam Yat Pad Pallavanaka Chandamani Chatai Bisphurji Takamapikabodushva Darshi Purunan Ragara Sasagara Saramurti Saradhikami Kadam Karoshi Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Ajanulambita Bhujau Kanuka Bodhato Sanketanai Kapitaru Kamala Yataksham Vishambaru Dijavaru Jugadharma Palo Bande Jagat Priyakaru Karuna Bhataru Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Namami Gange Tava Pada Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Diparupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavanurupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano Priyamanangamadapaharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavishanatham Vagi Shajushvadane Lakshmi Rijasacha Vakshashi Jasyaste Hide Sambhit Pam Nishingamaham Bhaji Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare, Hare. Jiyo hai kato achyuta vigar satima vitipta, Srishna anna tahastak udaram sravanam kutaschit, Grano annatahas chapaladrika chakaram saktir bhavo shapatna eva ghapatim lunanti jivai kato chuta vikarsati mavitipta srishno annatahas tak udaram sabanam kutaschit grano annatahas chapaladrika chakaram saktir bhavo shapatna eva ghapatim lunanti. Gaudiya Goshthipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, from this material bondage, who can save us? From this material bondage, who can save us? Only the personal associates of Gauranga, I mean Krishna, Bhagavan, they can save us from this fearful material world. There is tight bondage. Due to Maya, all bonded soul, they are going to lose their consciousness. Very tight bondage somehow, Maya re koriya jai charano na jai, Sadhuguru kipa bina na dekhi upai. Nobody can help us to cut bondage. Only Sadhuguru Vishnu, those who are the personal associates of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, they can help us. Gurudev can help us. Gurudev can help us to go out of this material bondage. Mittu, imminent danger, we are going to die. Who can save? Prabhupada speaking, we must keep our eyes open. We must keep our eyes open all the time to see who is guru, who is not. Of course, here another point is that 100% sincerity should be there, genuinity. In that case, we'll have to open our and demand should be there, 100%. That I want to know about the absolute truth. Then in that case, we'll have to watch the activities of different sadhus. Many times I talk. Who is guru, who is loghu, Prabhupada speaking, we must try to understand who is going to serve that Supreme Lord all the 24 hours. Purna Vastu. Who is going to serve that Purna Vastu all the time without wasting even a fraction of a second? He is actually Guru. Who is going to serve that absolute truth, Purna Vastu, all the time, without wasting even a fraction of time, fraction of second, is actually Guru.
Jai Govinda, Jai.
Actually, he is actually Guru. So continuously, we'll have to understand who is Guru, who is not. If I like to learn mathematics, if I like to learn English, all the time actually, who is going to help us to learn, you know, different language or different things. Prabhupada speaking, I am not speaking about that kind of cheap guru. Actually, they can help us to learn, because Bhaktivinoda Thakur also doing this kind of lila. Bhaktivinoda Thakur learning Sanskrit, education, everything from Vidyasagar. I can discuss this point sometime. He is the ocean of learning, Vidyasagar. Vidyasagar is the ocean of learning, but still, he is the ocean of material education. He is the ocean of material education, but still, he cannot cross over this material world. This kind of education, Prabhupada speaking, I am not speaking about this kind of education, because those teachers, they cannot save us from imminent danger. I mean, they cannot save us from our death. You already know Prabhupada speaking, Bhagavatam, from Srimad Bhagavatam we know, Gurur na sasyat, sajjano na sasyat, Pita na sasyat, sajjanani na sasyat, Daivam na sasyat, patin na sasyat, Namo chayadija samapeta mithim. Who cannot save us from imminent danger, death. Death, actually, I was discussing in Hindi Harikatha. Due to internet problem, I couldn't speak properly. But still, I like to discuss it here also. For those who are Mukta Purush, for them, death is a factor. Nothing there. What do you mean by death? In Shastra it is written, Mitur Atantik Vishthiti. You forget the connection of this world, I mean this life, what all happened in your life. You are going to cut your connection, you cannot keep in memory. You are going to die, my diamond, you are going to leave your body. And that Atma again going to enter into new body. So, Mittur Atvantik Vrishthiti. Atvantik Vrishthiti means you cannot remember anything. Sometime it happens, a miracle. You know, they can remember. But usually what I am saying, that also has some scientific background. Mittur Atvantik Vrishthiti. You cannot remember anything what all happened in your previous life. That is called mitu. I mean changing on your body, nothing else. So, I was bound to discuss this point, you can remember. Before going away, Gurudev speaking to Shukadev Goswami, Gurudev speaking to Parikshit Maharaj, Rajan, you are going to die. This kind of misconception, brutally conception, beastly conception, you should throw away. I am not going to elaborate. That means there is nothing. There is nothing. Death, what is death? Nothing. It is nothing. So, actually, Guru na sasa sa jano na sasa diya Prabhupada speaking, if Guru, my Gurudev not going to save me, cannot save me. Also before I was discussing about this point, Prabhupada speaking, I am going to submit unto the lotus feet of such a Guru who can give me 100% spiritual benefit. I am not going to submit unto the lotus feet of half Guru. I am not going to submit unto the lotus feet of half Guru. I am going to submit unto lotus feet of Prabhupada speaking, I am going to submit unto the lotus feet of such a guru who can give me 100% spiritual benefit, who can deliver me. So we all must remember this point. That is very important. Because the main problem is the full, we are going to pay our full attention to this material world or material things related to material body and mind. That is the main problem. That is the main problem. Our ignorance is there. So, due to ignorance, we are going to die. If there is knowledge, tatvajnan, then surely we are not going to die. Because there is no question of death. The kind of education we are collecting, the kind of education we are collecting from this material world, maybe MA, PhD, London or Philadelphia, in Los Angeles, you can do. But this kind of education cannot stand with me. Only for this life it is valuable. Also, even in this life itself, it can become useless. When somebody become paralysis, brain paralysis, brain stroke, everything, then he is very highly educated. He got all education from foreign country, anything, everything. But still, if he is going to, you know, become a paralytic patient, if he or she can go mad, in that case, he or she cannot remember the education he already collected in his life. I mean, the education is useless. But what Prabhupada wants to speak, paramarthik vidvā, I can promise you, I can 100% I can challenge, if you are going to hear all Harikatha from heart, not drama, from heart, with full demand, with full sincerity, then I can also promise from this Vyasasana that you are not going to forget this vidvā. Provided you are going to give me full attention, and you are going to show your sincerity, then even in the next life, what all education you are going to get now, next life you can have that teaching in within your, you know, with Atma. Eternal education not going to leave that Atma. By material education, new, every time you are going to take path, you will have to, according to your previous sanskar, you can express interest and accordingly you can lead your life this way. He who is going to give me, you know, indulgence in my fanciful attitude, I like to enjoy my, you know, hand and leg and all my sense organ like to run for enjoyment. And if Guru going to give me permission, okay, yes, you know, so tough, you know, you can enjoy something, you can go and take some enjoyment. He's going to give me indulgence in my enjoyment, material enjoyment, by the help of, you know, speech, hand, leg, all sense organs, who is going to give me some lucrative offer. Surely he is a cheater, Prabhupada speaking. He is not Guru. Guru is very tough, very heavy. If Guru cannot save me from this kind of problem, bonded condition, then who is Guru? He surely is not Guru. And if he is going to save me anyway, at all condition, if I am staying in front of Guru, or maybe for some seva reason I am staying thousands of kilometers away from Guru, still Guru has some handling, controlling over me, provided I am 100% inclined. Guru Tattva. Prabhupada speaking, in the beginning of every year, in the beginning of every month, in the beginning of every week, in the beginning of every days, in the beginning of every moment, we must worship that kind of guru to go out of this material bondage. We feel comfortable. That is called Maya. We feel comfortable, but we don't understand this is Maya. If we feel comfortable with this material enjoyment, material prosperity, all decoration, everything, all, that means we are in Maya. Our attention is not there unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, 100%. How many types of bonded jivas are there? How many types of bonded jivas are there? There are five kinds of bonded souls there. Namely, those whose consciousness is completely covered, is called Achadita Chetan. Bhaktivinoda will all discuss, still I like to touch it. Those whose consciousness is completely covered up is called Achadita Chetan. Those whose consciousness is contracted, Sankuchito. And those whose consciousness is burning slightly, Mukulita Chetan. And those with developed consciousness, Bikochita Chetan, and those who are with full-fledged consciousness. Full-fledged consciousness is called Purna Bikochita Chetan. It's called Purna Bikochita Chetan. Purna Bikochita Chetan, I mean consciousness, there is no covering over his consciousness, fully clean and clear. Follow. About this point, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu repeatedly told us, we forget this point. Cheta Darpana Marjanam Bhava Mahanda Bhagni Nivapanam. This is the slope. The more you are interested about Savan Kirtan, Aprakita Harikatha Kirtan, the more you are interested to digest, the more you are interested to apply in your own life the symptom of sadhu. In that case, surely you can get some clue. You can get some green signal. Follow. According to Achinta Vedabhat Tattva, we must remember that from the qualitative perspective of Chit Dharma, there is oneness between Krishna and Jiva and the Jivas. But from the qualitative perspective of their essential nature and individual personality, Sarupa, there is eternal difference. Countless difference and diversities. We should not express doubt about you, about this point. I can discuss day by day. There is countless diversity, even about bhakti, there is countless diversity you can find. Among all panchabandhav, five of them, each of them going to express different kind of bhakti. They are doing bhakti, I have some speciality. Uttara Mataji going to express different kind. Kunti Mataji separate. Subhadra Mataji separate. All different kind of, you know. Actually, Subhadra is a bhakti, you know, still I am speaking, is doing Leela. Subhadra is a bhakti devi. A Jagannath always Subhadra there, bhakti mantra speaking. Anyway, this way, countless diversity of bhakti itself we can find. So, Mamai Bhamsa Jiva Loke Jiva Bhutta Sanatana, It's okay. All Jivatma, all ultimately coming from Tatastha Shakti of Bhagavan. So, qualitative perspective, you know, if you think, there is some. But Chit Dharma, from the qualitative perspective of Chit Dharma, there is oneness, the same, similar, between Krishna and the Jivas. But from the quantitative perspective of their essential nature and individual personalities, sarupa, there is eternal difference between. So Achinto Vedaved, this Tattva, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Achinto Vedaved, Bhaktivinoda Thakur repeatedly speaking, this Ved and Aved. Vedaved, first of all speaking Ved, after the Aved. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, when we are going to discuss this point, Vedaved, be sure about this Vedaved Tattva. Ved, I mean the difference is, it is a prominent, very prominent. Bhaktivinoda speaking, when Vedaved Tattva you are speaking, be sure, out of this Ved and Aved, Ved is very prominent. Follow. But Aved is also there. You know, Aved is also there, but Aved is like, you know, you cannot touch it. You cannot directly feel it. Like the sky is there. You know sky is there, but you cannot feel it. This way, Aved. So Aved means only Chetan, Chit, particle, this end. Despite the eternal oneness, it is a perception of different, it is a perception of difference that the eternally, that the difference I already told is prominent. Though the Aveda Sarupa is an accomplished fact or objective, but still there is no indication that any such state has independent existence. Theoretically true, also feeling we can bring, but it's, you cannot, directly you cannot see. Rather, it is a manifestation of Nitya Veda, eternal difference, that is always prominent, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. In other words, where the eternal difference and eternal oneness are present simultaneously, but still the perception of Veda is always strong, prominent. I already told you. Similarly, in the case of Ishvara and the Jivas, non-difference or oneness is not part of the essential identity. Even at the stage of Sarvasiddhi, just as the house can be called both A and B, both of them. This way, actually, in one house, both of them can stay, so we can say both name, we can say. This way we are going to speak, actually. Now point is there, the Jiva forgets her true nature. Vidya and Avidya, I already told. Vidya and Avidya, both eternally present inside Jivatma. So, Avidya is also there. So, Vidya and Avidya both there, eternally present, according to time and circumstances. I mean by the help of Sadhu Sangha, Vidya can get exposed, and due to Maya, Avidya can grasp us. So, Vidya and Avidya, both eternally present inside Jivatma. So, Avidya sown by bonded soul, since time immemorial or beginningless, already I told you. The Jiva forgets her true nature. The Jiva forgets her true nature, actually. All living beings are embodiments of eternality. All living beings are embodiments of eternality. Knowledge and bliss, but because they are minute parts of the Supreme Brahman, I mean Jyoti, light particle, light, Chit particle, they have forgotten their true nature. Being thus deluded, they are, due to Maya, they are feeling some problem. They have fallen into the cycle of repeated birth and death. Punarapi jananam, punarapi mananam, punarapi matri yashare sayanam. This way, birth and death, the beginningless ignorance, the beginningless ignorance created by Sri Krishna's potency of illusion, Maya. The fact you know already, Bhagavan eternally present, all countless bonded souls, they are eternally present, Maya is also eternally present, all eternal. But still, beginning, end, this, that, we are always thinking this way. And also, though Krishna Bhuli Sejib Anadi Vairmu, but still, Maya can come to an end. Though we know, there is bondage, but still this bondage in Maya can come to an end. Not that can stay forever. Maya can go away, so Maya can go away, not that Maya can stay. This way, by the influence of Krishna's energy, Maya, which has created illusion from the time immemorial, the Jiva forgets the true of her own constitutional nature, that I am part and parcel of Parabrahma Paratpara Akhileshwar Bhagavan Supreme Lord. My nature is to show eternal existence. My nature is to be eternally existent, full of knowledge and bliss. Thus deluded in forgetfulness of this, she falls into this material existence, this is the material world. The living being's identification with the material world, I mean, while we are in this material world, we are going to identify ourselves with respect to some material identity. We are going to express some material identity all the time. We are going to say, my name is this, that, my address, everything we are speaking. So the living being's identification with the material world, an ego, false ego, that is a product of illusion, is not only erroneous, but according to the consideration of conclusive truth, it is possible. The Jiva can never be in a conditioned state of material existence, not possible. But still we are watching that all Jiva, they are in Maya. Also, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that the jivas, they have their material body, sense organ, everything. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Jaiva Dharma, though those materially bonded jivas, they have their material body, sense organ, everything. Similarly, chit body is very fine body. Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to confirm that the jiva is an infinitesimal entity endowed by her very nature with consciousness, thus she has knowledge. She possesses self-identity, is an enjoyer, a thinker, and an intelligent being. The jiva is the proprietor of an eternal identity that is extremely exotic and subtle. We cannot see it, but it is surely there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. The material human body is made up of panchabhut, khiti apa tej marot brahm, and all different kind of limbs, and we can see ears and nose, etc. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Similarly, the spiritual body of the jiva is also there. Perfect spiritual features there secretly, but it is not covered up. This is her eternal form. When the jiva becomes conditioned soul, I mean bonded, you already know, I am not going to explain in details, two different upadhis, I mean titles coming, false identities going to cover up. These two upadhis, titles, I mean false identities going to cover her, cover the atomic, eternal, spiritual form. First cover is a material body, linga sarir, subtle body, and the second is gross physical body. We cannot avoid it. Unavoidable for the conditioned jiva, we cannot avoid. It's a must. Anyway, but repeatedly we are hearing one point that nitya siddha krishna prem sadhu gobunoy. First of all, you remember the sloka I started with is very important, and the explanation by Prabhupada I already discussed. I have discussed. Jivai kato achyuta vikarsati ma vitipta. My tongue, Prahlad Maharaj crying in front of Nrisimhadev. My tongue going to pull me in one direction. Jivai kato achyuta vikarsati ma vitipta. I am not getting satisfaction. Srishno, my lower organ, you know, linga, going to put me in trouble. Also my appetite, I mean belly, going to put me in trouble. My hearing organ also going to put me in trouble, going to pull me in one direction, another direction, kutaschit. And my smell, nose, you know, this organ going to pull me another direction, or karma shakti, my power of doing something by hand and leg, everything, eyes, nose, everything, all sense organ. Jivai kata achyuta vikarsati mahabhitipta. Oh Prabhu, I am not getting any satisfaction, all the time I am feeling trouble. This way, Sishna annataha stab, my touching, you know, this is my skin, tocha, in Hindi we speak, skin, also going to put me in trouble. This way, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, this is just like, you know, a man with so many wives, just a man with so many wives in problem. Just a man with so many wives cannot satisfy. Big problem, all different problems, you know, can come. About Abhidya Prabhupada always speaking, only by the association of pure Guru Vishnu we can cut our Abhidya. But be careful, our Sangha, what we are doing, if you are doing genuine Sangha, then it is possible. If you are hearing Harikatha, actually we are not doing Sangha. Sangha means, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, Sangha means attachment. Sangha means attachment. If attachment is not there, I have my attachment, my material property, everything, decoration, these are so many things, attachment for material prosperity, then surely you can go on doing satsanga, but in the name of satsanga, you are doing a satsanga because you are not paying attention. You are going to misuse. So this way depends upon satsanga, genuine satsanga. Satsanga can never go in vain. All different Narad Pancharatri already told. It's amogha, money without fail. Like Vajra, Vajra, no? Thunder. Indra, Vajra, Indra going to throw Vajra, Vajra, inevitable. Like Brahmastra, inevitable. No question of failure. So this way, satsanga, genuine satsanga, if I am crying inside my heart, this, if I am crying inside my heart, if I am crying to watch my painful situation, then it is possible, otherwise not. If I am not crying inside to get proper sadhu sangha, I can give the example of Naraji Maharaj. I can come to this point. Prajujyamane, this sloka also I can discuss. How it is possible for Naraji Maharaj? Naraji Maharaj, previous life, doing satsanga, genuine satsanga, not false satsanga. Say, in the name of satsanga, so many rubbish things going on. Maharaj, satsanga can never go vain. Never go in vain. Never can come up failure. Impossible. So Naraji Maharaj, the example of Naraji Maharaj is just fitting here. Naraji Maharaj from very poor family, very poor mother. She cannot even arrange, you know, two-time parade. Anyway, but Naraji Maharaj, when getting satsanga, sadhu sangha, is feeling attachment. It is written there. Naraji Maharaj speaking in front of Vyasadeva Goswami. Though I was very small boy, usually those small boys, they are having tremendous attraction for playing game. But Naraji Maharaj speaking, the sadhu going to show some exclusive kipa to me, because they never find with me any chanchal bhav. They never find any chanchal bhav with me. Even I am less interested to play. I like their kirtan, harikatha, prasadam. This way attachment means, oh, sadhu is there, I can earn money and give to sadhu. This is very wrong conception. If you are not going to take all achar, acharan, adarsha, everything from that sadhu, then your earning money, if you are giving to that sadhu, is dangerous. You don't like to take, because that is reaction. Follow. In this context, I like to give you a reminder that Bhaktin Mukhi Sukriti and Bhagavan Mukti Sukriti, at all, if you are initiated, I don't like to give pain to you. Actually, I like to open the truth, absolute discussion. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, so many people taking initiation, but that is initiation, so-called initiation. That is not actually initiation. That means I can take it granted that they are not initiated properly. They are not initiated properly. Though they are doing chanting, earning this, that, but their initiation is not proper. That's why they are not getting any result. At the same time also I can show you, surely they are not 100% interested to know their absolute truth. They have no such feeling. They have no such feeling that I am going to die any time. Like Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami used to speak many times. We are going to die any time. So I must be very sincere. Maybe lack of sincerity there. Maybe Gurudev is okay. You are not sincere. Or maybe Gurudev is false. You are, it cannot so happen because it's a Siddhanta Virodh. Because you are, if you are 100% sincere, then it is the duty of Baldaji Maharaj to guide you properly. It is a duty. Chaitya Guru in the form of Chaitya Guru, Shiksha Guru, or Baldaji Maharaj can guide you. Now point is there. If you are not properly initiated, that means if you are not properly initiated, initiation not done, so-called initiation, in that case I can take it granted that you are not at all initiated. In that case, if you are chanting on it, earning money, giving to sadhu, it can bring some bhoganmukhi sukriti. You can test in your life. You can earn money and go on spending, give to a pure sadhu. Go on giving sadhu. So you cannot get bhakti because you don't want bhakti. No demand is there. Even up to today, I have not seen such a jivatma with a tremendous tenacity to get bhakti only. All he likes to throw. He is going to express this direct feeling. Enough of it, I have seen this material life. Such a jivatma is rare. Maybe there, but it's really rare. Maybe there. So if that jivatma going to earn money, give, then all he cannot get bhakti because he don't want bhakti. He is going to expect material prosperity. In lieu of seva, in return of seva, he like to do some seva. It is not actually seva, this word not applicable. Because seva is related to Bhagavan, Bhakta. Okay, he like to do some seva. Okay, I can speak seva. Material, not totally material, I'm going to do seva, some seva. But that is not actually pure seva, first point. Second, if he is going to do some seva, that seva cannot beget bhakti, cannot give bhakti. Because he is less interested to get bhakti, eternal thing, bhakti. Only want to do some seva externally, so he can surely get bhoganmukha sukriti. Bhoganmukha means, there is two kinds of sukriti, one is bhaktin mukhi sukriti. That kind of sukriti can give you bhakti, can give you inspiration to go in the way of your devotional line. Bhakti mukhi, you can also get power also, bhakti mukhi sukriti, by hearing Harikatha, adopting in your life. Like mad, you like to hear Harikatha, okay. But those who are with some plan, going to do some seva, external seva, they are going to get some bhagavan mukhi sukriti. If they are going to pay 10,000 rupees to one sadhu, they are going to give lakhs of rupees, 10 times. That is not actually blessing. They think it is good. So Mayadevi is going to cheat you finally this way. Some people can say, Maharaj, he has done Guru Seva in life. Yes, I know. I know he has done Guru Seva externally. But in return, he wanted to get establishment as Acharya, second Acharya. After Gurudev. He wanted to get more big affluences. He never wanted to get pure devotion. I can touch Bhagavata and say, So that's why he's not getting it. Only money and money coming. Yeah. Like one man going to throw all garbage into dustbin, like money can come. And that money can come, all appearances, that is very dangerous. Out of Bhagavad-Mukta Sukriti, you can put yourself in more and more trouble. Never mind, that day I told, that's why I told. Sometimes you are in confusion, why Maharaj speaking this way? Why I told, the condition of disciple is far better than guru. It's a revolting word, Siddhanta. But I can prove it. 100% I can prove it. The condition of that bonded soul who is going to take diksha from some so-called guru, his condition far better than that, because his bonded condition is more tight. He can never get free. Impossible. So those who are interested to get Bhagavan-mukhi Sukriti, they are serving Guru Vishnu. Actually, Guru Vishnu don't like to take anything, but what to do? Sometimes taking and using in seva. With this mood, if you go on seva, then bonded condition, five kind of bonded condition, I already told you can remember. I was discussing this point. Very, very important thing. So anyway, Naradji, in the case of Naradji, I can show, Naradji was very much interested to hear Harikatha, understand. I mean, Naradji Maharaj never wanted to get anything. Bancha Kalpatarvasya, you see, we are speaking, na? Bancha Kalpatarvasya, we shielding tree. If you pay Vrindavan to Guru Vishnu doing some service, in return, if you have some secret demand, then you can never get bhakti, you can get it fulfilled in your life. Follow. This way, whole world in danger. They are less interested to hear about this point. So you see, the Naraji Maharaj was in bonded condition because Sarup Siddha Narad and eternally Narad. Two, I cannot discuss it right now, you can feel confusion. So this way actually, all in bonded condition. You know, Naraji Maharaj eternally present, Naraji, and another is Siddha Narad. Bhajan Siddha Narad. They are going to get Siddhi. So, previous life, Narad speaking, this Narad, actually, somebody going to do bhajan with the mood of Nanda Maharaj, Yasodama, that doesn't mean they can become a separate Nanda Yasoda. Nanda doesn't mean. They can get Seva Sukh, they can go and enter into Naraji Maharaj, they can go on doing this way. Actually, point is there, Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhu Govunai. I already told. So, Naraji Maharaj actually, previous life, going to give example. So, after that, what happens? When going to live, there is no desire, separate desire. Continuously is thinking about how to, get bhakti. This way, finally he is going to live, and Bhagavan also coming in his own life, in his life, just for a fraction of second. And when Naraji Maharaj crying heavily, Bhagavan, I like to see you, I like to meet you. Bhagavan speaking, no. Now, you cannot see me. Not possible. Because there is there inside heart there is a Cheta Darpana Marjanam is not properly done. There is some kasai. In Sanskrit or Bengali we say kasai. Kasai means some mark, some marking, some small marking, the smell there. If kasai, I mean this marking is not there, smell is still there, then Bhagavan cannot. Give darshan, that is the main thing. Durdarsha aham ku yoginam. Anibritta kasai. Those were still today some smell is there of bondage. Smell. In that case, Bhagavan cannot come. Give darshan. Bhagavan cannot help you. This way. Duddarsha aham ku yogi nam. Ku yogi mean properly guru karan, properly bhajan. Ku yogi nam mean those are trying, but if this their effort is wrong effort. There are so many things I like to discuss actually, but previous day I was discussing about how Mayavadis they are also trying to do bhajan. Mayavadi, they are also trying to do bhajan, but their bhajan is false bhajan, they are not true. So, last time I was discussing about this sloka, you can remember. Abhidayam antaryavartamanaha swayam dhiraha panditamannamanaha jangjannamanaha parishanti mura andhen naivo niyamana yathandha. They are traveling in this material world repeatedly, again and again. Who? They have, those who are not interested to collect proper tattva jnan. They are not going to get proper satsanga. Those who are mayavadi, they are also speaking satsanga. I am laughing, they are speaking, I satsanga. But they are actually, they don't know it is not satsanga, they are mayavadi. So, due to avidya, they are busy with their kama, kamma, karma, didrata. They are going to collect some material knowledge in the form of, you know, shastra. But it is material knowledge. Their knowledge is not aprakita knowledge. They think we are learned man. We are dhira, very peaceful. But they don't know. They are going to bring more and more, you know, anartha in their life. They are going to bring more and more anartha. Like Brahma already told, na? Arijya kritchena parampadam tataha patati adho anadita jishmadam rayo. In Mundaka Upanishad, that sloka you already speak. Also in Mundaka Upanishad, also another sloka like this is here. Avidyayam bahudha vartamana vayam kitartha iti abhimannanti balaha yat karmani no pravedayanti ragat tenaturaha khino lokas shabante. They are foolish, number one, murka. They are busy with karma kanda, they think we are very about Advaita Gosai Tattva also I was speaking. So many karma kandi pandit, they think we are very big pandit, but they are under avidya. They think we are very successful. We are very successful, kitartha. We have done a lot of, you know, auspicious job, this, that. But they have their desire to get involved in karmakanda. So naturally due to karmakanda procedure, they can go up to heaven and from there they can be kicked out by demigods from there. They are going to collect some result, so they are going to enjoy in heavenly planet. After that, those demigods, they can kick them out. Follow. Like Nahus Maharaj, you can, Nahus going there, up, Nahus Maharaj, up in Sarga. When he was doing so much problems, so much, all Sukriti gone, due to pap, aparat, finally he was thrown in this ground, on this ground, as a python, Nahus Maharaj. So this way, in Ishopanishad, it is written such clearly, in Ishopanishad, it is written so clearly that you can understand very easily. But those Mayavadi, due to Maya, they cannot understand. They think we are Pandit. They are also going to read, this sloka, but they cannot remember the meaning, they cannot understand. Andham tamaha pravishanti je aviddham upasate tato bhuyo ivo te tamo ya uviddayam rata. It is from Ishu Upanishad. You can go through Upanishad and read. It is written, Andhyam tamaha pravishanti je aviddham upasati. Those who are going to worship avidya, about avidya, I was discussing at the time of Vishnupriya Devi there. Those who are busy with material education, this, that, all avidya. Bhaktivinoda was speaking now. Maya vidya, jada vidya, yato mayar vaibhav, tomar bhajane badha, anitya sansare moho janmiya jibke kare gadha. Can make a jiva gadha, as mean useless. So, they are going to, Vidyasagar also thinking, I am a great learned man, but what use? After death, Vidyasagar cannot remember about previous all education he received in this material, all vanish. Maybe according to previous, you know, sanskar, get some feeling. I can read Vyakaran again. It can be there, but knowledge cannot stay. Because material knowledge cannot stay after death. That is the main problem. Material knowledge cannot stay after death. Mittur attantiki visruti. Visruti means vishesh rupe. Very, very special forgetfulness. Not that you can forget and you can remember. Not that. Special forgetfulness. You cannot remember. Tani aham veda no janaha. Krishna speaking to Arjun, infinity pure jivatma going on. I am also there with jivatma. But what all birth you took before, or I can remember, and I can, but you cannot remember. Countless birth, I have taken birth here, I mean incarnation, Bhagavan coming here. Tani aham vedaha. All that I can remember, but you cannot remember. It is the, though Arjun is not bonded soul, but Bhagavan going to, you know, arrange the situation in such a way, on behalf of all bonded jivas, Arjuna is now representative, so he must understand this point very clearly. Mittur attantik visriti. That is why I told you, Gajendra somehow doing some bhajan. Gajendra previous life. I mean, that Indodumna Raja. So he forget everything. Indodumna Raja now when taking birth in the form of elephant, no more he can remember that I am elephant. I am actually Indodumna Raja. Cannot remember. Follow. Indodumna Raja cannot remember. You know. He forget now due to his previous abhyas. Due to his previous life doing something, he can remember the mantra. Somehow he remember.
due to bhajan power. Only this thing he can remember. But Jada Bharat, due to bhajan power and, you know, it was a special blessing. He could remember previous life I was this, almost, because he was almost at the gate of success. He was almost at the gate of success. And there was no aparad. That is a special thing. Jada Bharat ji not going to make any aparad. Only because he is going to, you know, develop attachment for that dear baby, that is that much. That is why, by the mercy of Bhagavan, he can remember previous life I was at the gate of success, but I couldn't come out successful. He can remember. But the case of Indradyumna Raja is not like that. Indradyumna Raja going to forget because he was doing aparad unto lotus feet of Agastya Muni. He is doing arsip, but is not going to pay dandavat pranam, everything, giving honor to Rishi. Whereas Rishi already coming to his bhajan kutir there. And Dronachal Parvat there. He is not paying. That's why by the curse of that Rishi, he took birth in the form of elephant. He cannot remember. Now, because Bhagavan speaking, my bhajan, result of my bhajan, anyhow, if you are doing bhajan, anyhow mean not that fanciful. Anyhow, mane in Ganmar, Karmamag, successful bhajan if you do. Anyhow, if you are Karmarpan, Bhagavan speaking, okay, he is doing at least something, going to offer to me, I will have to repay him. Bhagavan cannot forget. Bhagavan is Kritagya. Bhagavan is Kritagya. What all Jivatma are doing, Bhagavan can remember everything. All material people, if you are going to do something, some benefit, they can forget. They like to kill me. They like to, you know, go against me. But Bhagavan never, Guru Vishnu never do that. Bhagavan remember. What all you are doing, any kind of efforts, bhajan effort you are doing sincerely, properly, Bhagavan can remember, like to pay you. So, actually, Gajendra, previous life was doing bhajan. So, anyway, somehow when he was in problem, going to concentrate on this point, nobody there to save me, his all sense organ and mind going to, you know, show some inner, you know, mood, inner attraction. I like to think inside. Outside help, all failure, now it was sick inside her. Then he immediately remember, and that is why it is written that Jajapa Paramam Japyam Praga Janmanu Shikshitam. He started doing japa. Previous life he was doing this japa. Jajapa paramam japyam praga janmanu shikshitam. Previous life he was doing this japa. So suddenly he remembered, well, it is known to me, so I can take shelter of Supreme Lord. Anyway, I was. Now, this way, Bhagavan was very artho, jigyasu, artharthi, chagani. So many discussion can be there with these four points. Follow. Artho, jigyasi, arthartha, chagani. These four types of people, they are going to do bhajan, but not a matter of joke. Each and every part, if you like to discuss in details, then you can understand, not a matter of joke. Follow. Artho, jigyasu, arthartha, chagani. Oh, Gajendra is artho. I am not going to discuss in detail, but I can give example. Artho mean those who are in trouble, problem, and so going to seek the help of Supreme Lord, going to do bhajan. They are in problem, they are in trouble, painful situation. They like to go out of this painful situation. This is called artho. Follow. Jigyasu, you can speak about Sanakadi Rishi or about Jigyasu, Parikshit Maharaj also Jigyasu. Arjuna also jigyasu. Artharthi Dhruva Maharaj. First of all, he wanted to get some facility. I mean, wanted to sit on the throne of the king. He was not allowed by Uttanapad to sit there because the second wife was against. You know. That's why Dhruva Maharaj was very sorry. He was interested to sit there. That's why he started doing Vajartati. You know, Gani also, this, you know, Ganmishra Bhakti, he was doing. There is so many judgment, discussion, you know. In Gita, it is written actually, we'll have to discuss in details actually, about Bharatji Maharaj, you can say, Gani Bhakta. Gani, or Sanakadi, or Chatusan, you know, Chatusan. Sanak, Sanandan, Sanatan, Chatusan, they are also Ganichar Bhakta. But by the mercy of, you know, Bhagavan, previously they got the chance to satsanga. That's why they could reach up to that point. So they are Gani Bhakta. There is so much division. Artho mean all artho, and finally what situation can be there in their life so that they can start bhajan. Follow. Artho. Jigyasu also, there is a different kind of moods are there. With what point, what mood you are going to put question. That is also big important. So this way, so many discussion we should do. So now, actually, those Mayavadi, you can go to Varanasi, you can go to Haridwar, so many Harikatha were there, many times in Haridwar, there. So I know it for sure, there. They are doing their Harikatha, they are discussing, those Mayavadi. Outside people, they have no information about this point, that this is not at all Harikatha. This is not at all satsanga, but they don't know. All rich people, everybody coming in there. Everybody coming and paying the Maharaj, Dandava. They don't know this is not satsanga. Only and only if you are going to take the association of a devotee, pure devotee, having no expectation other than serving Krishna, that kind of satsanga we should expect. Otherwise, all other satsanga is not perfect satsanga. So, perfect satsanga is rare. That's why Jagadananda Pandit speaking, Kolikale Sadhupava Kuthin Janiya. Jagadananda speaking, Pandit writing in Prem Vivartha that in Kalikal, it is very, very typical, very difficult to get a real sadhu. All in the guise of sadhu. Most of them. I am not speaking. You can chase me, you can go against me, I can show Bhagavatam also. In Bhagavatam also I can show. You can come, I can show. Bhagavat glorification there, more there. Follow. There is written clearly. Then in Kalikal, this kind of sadhu, you can see, is very rare. It's a matter of chance. How we can meet with a pure sadhu? Bhaktivinoda Thakur also writing. Chaitanya Sikha here, there are so many places. In Jaiva Dharma also. So, you know, there is it written. Also, you can remember, previous day I was discussing about this point, do you remember? I forgot. I couldn't discuss this in detail. The all Jivatma, they are according to the fanciful attitude running. They have no idea about sadhu, this, that. And so, it is written in Bhagavatam. Previous day I was discussing, Tarvo kinna jivanti bhastra kinna sasanti uta na khadanti na mehanti kingam pasavo apare.
What?
Tarvo kinna jivanti bhastaha kinna sasanti uta na khadanti na mehanti kingam pasavo apare.
The question is that those trees,
they are not living. They are not living entity. Those trees, they are not living entities. And those the blower in the house of blacksmith, you know, one blower. Always, oxygen flowing. One by one, blowing, blower. A blower also taking exhalation on inhalation, like this. So, Sukadeva Goswami is speaking, Tarabho king na jivanti bhastaha king na sasanti uto na khadanti na mihanti king gama pasavo yapare.
So, the blower not habituated to take exhalation and inhalation. They are habituated. So, they are actually living being not. So, ordinary man, they are also going to increase garbage in this material world. Yesterday, while after Harikatha, I was crossing the board, I was speaking in the board in front of some educated, you know, young batches, that when the number of human being increasing in the world, then big danger. When the number of animal increasing, that's not a big problem, because at present, those who are taking bird, they are more or less or more dangerous than beast. That is the main problem. Because of beast, like tiger or, you know, sometimes they can attack an element because they are feeling appetite. But a human being, when coming down to such a low level, they can do anything. What not they can do. They can do anything. They can do anything. One man when going down and down, especially Vishwanatha Chakravarti again, is Pakhanda. Previously, they somehow started bhakti, but later on they lose their bhakti, lose their faith in Guru Vaishnava, like Kalapahar. I can give the example, not now, no time. Kalapahar was from a very, very high class Brahmin family. He started bhakti. He is very nice. But ultimately, he lose bhakti due to some reason. I can discuss someday. And he becomes so dangerous. Even Muslim people, they are not so dangerous like Kalapahar. They are going to break all temples. They have to demolish all temples. Also, Kalapahar wanted to destroy Jagannath temple also by the help of the power of King Delivasa. Follow? So dangerous. So when a man going to commit aparad, day by day his or her consciousness going down due to kapat bhav, and that consciousness going to zero level or even negative level. Zero level still okay, negative level. Like Sukhdev Goswami, externally going to show zero level first, but now positive level. This way, those trees are not they living entity? They are also living in, or the blower in the house in the workshop of, you know, a blacksmith, they are also exhalation and. And those dogs, the street dogs, I mean village dogs, they are not taking, they are not taking foods, and they are not going to pass stool. This way, Sukhdev Goswami, Maharaj Sukhdev Goswami Pa,
wanted to give us a direct feeling of the painful situation of bonded soul. What those village dogs, the street dogs, they are not going to eat, they are not going to take food, they are not going to pass stools, they are not going to, you know, take oxygen. What do you mean? So only the symptom of human being, only two legs, two eyes, two ears, two hands, that doesn't mean I am a man. Maybe I am more than an animal. Very dangerous. So this way, Tarabo king na jivanti vasta king na sasanti utho na khadanti na mehanti king kama pasava apare. Without bhakti, so many documents I can show. Without bhakti, if those are material people, they are going to increase their number. They are going to give birth to different babies, this and that, and the number of human being increasing, but not, they are not actually human being. They are not doing their duty. So this way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also going to express his concern, deep concern. I already told many times, you can remember. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you find the number of renounced order, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you find the number of renounced order, like sannyas, you know, brahmachari, the number of brahmachari sannyas is increasing, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it must be a plotting of maya. At present, anybody like to take permission from me, Maharaj, I like to enter into renounced order, you know, no, I said, no, you go. Still you are okay, in grihastha life. You can become kapat and you can go down and down. You know, I never permit. If I can find such a jivatma, just appropriately, you know, can enjoy the approval of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then I can also approve. But at present I cannot see. They are going to kapat. Bah. This way, if the number of Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if the number of renounce order, I mean sannyasi, brahmachari, the number of those, you know, increasing, then it must be a plotting of maya, because maya going to make confusion among people, common people. Maya going to make confusion among common people so that they cannot understand who is sadhu, who is not. If they can understand who is sadhu, then surely Jada, Brahmo, Bhamo, this sloka I already discussed. If they are going to meet with one sadhu, pure sadhu, and of course if there is no previous aparad, then they can feel attraction for that. They can go ahead. So this way, in the dress of renounce order, they are going to Ortholav, Eya Se, Brahmya Phira, Dashe Deshe, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. With this mood of collecting money only, Ortholav, Eya Se, with this mood of collecting money from all over the world, they are earning. You can sow, you can go and watch them, what they are doing. They cannot make themselves free. They cannot make themselves free. How they can make free? Make you free. They cannot even, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Artholavi yase bhamya phili deshe deshe. Follow. This way, in Bhagavatam, tomorrow I can discuss, in Bhagavatam you can see that those who are in renounce order, what is the condition and what Bhagavatam speaking, we can discuss. Those who are giving spiritual lecture, what is their situation? Why they are sitting in high chair, where their situation is very bad. This way, all different kind of confusion can come. So first of all over the world, they should hear Vaishnava Tattva, Guru Tattva. And in applied form, from the life of Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Sridhara Goswami Maharaj, Bhaktivinoda Puri Goswami Maharaj, they can go on watching their life activities, everything. Only philosophy cannot change their life.
They have to go. So Bhaktivinoda was speaking also, daily at least you have to discuss the life history. Ramanuja Charya also speaking. Also, you'll have to discuss about the life history of Guru Vaishnava. At least, very daily we'll have to discuss. To protect yourself. There is Maya, so much, too much Maya. So this way, there is big problem. So, those who are Mayavadi, they are also speaking, we are doing satsanga, but we cannot speak that they are doing satsanga. Surely they are not doing satsanga, asatsanga. Otherwise, so many slokas speak from Mundaka Upanishad, this, that. Also from Isha Upanishad, I speak, Andham Tamaha Pravishanti Je Aviddham Upashati. Those were upasati meaning upo asana. Upo asana, upasana mean everybody is speaking, upasana mean worshipping. In general word we are using this. In general sense we are using worshipping. And actually as per Sanskrit grammar, if you like to discuss, upasana mean upo asana. Upo asana, upasana. Upasana means upamana samipe. In front of, suppose I am like to do, I am doing upasana of Gurudev. Upasana means I will have to sit in front of Gurudev to do upasana. Follow. So maybe Guru Maharaj is gone, but when I am mentally worshipping, Guru Maharaj is in front of me. Upasana means you will have to sit in front of your worshipable object. Upasana. So surely when you are going to do avidya, you are going to worship avidya. I mean when you are going to do worship dushta saraswati, wicked saraswati, material saraswati, so surely all people all over the world they are worshipping saraswati. I mean those who have knowledge about saraswati, Vedic culture, they are at least approval. Not that. Everybody mean those who have belief, they are going to worship. So surely they are going to face avidya, maya. Avidya is also maya. Maya are by Bhaktivinoda Thakur already told. So those who are going to worship avidya, I mean material saraswati. Avidya means material saraswati, maya. So be it Vidyasagar or Raja Ram Mohan, anybody. I am not going to specifically speak. Those who are going to worship avidya, they are surely they are going to put themselves in bondage, big bondage. Vidyasagar may be the ocean of learning, but still he cannot make himself free from the clutches of maya, satvarajo. So what kind of vidya? Now it is written. Andham tamaha pravishanti je avidya upasati. It is sure those who are going to worship avidya, it is sure those who are going to do worship avidya, surely they are going to enter tama. They are going to enter tama. Tama means darkness, ignorance. Follow. But in comparison, if you are going to compare, those Mayavadi, they are going to enter into more and more tama. Because it is written, Andham tamaha pravishanti je avidyam upasati. And tato bhuyo, more and more darkness, more and more ignorant can be there in the life of those who are Uvidyam upasati. Uvidyam means they are going to exceed Supreme Lord. They are going to take the chair of Supreme Lord. Uvidyam. U means exceptional. You know, Prabhupada speaking, those Mayavadi, they are actually Joshi Sanghi.
Those Mayavadi, they are actually just, they can externally, they can prove. Externally, they can prove they have no interest for money, position. Not. Externally, they can prove this way in front of this ignorant people, foolish people of the world. We have no attraction for money, position, etc. But Prabhupada speaking, they are topmost, you know, Jashishangi. Because they like to get the post of Brahma. They like to get the post of Brahma. That's why they are topmost Jashit Sanghi. Pratishtha Jashit. They like to say, no, Prabhupada Saraswati are also speaking this way. Many times I told in my Harikatha. You know? Many times I told Prabhupada Saraswati was speaking that they are going to, you know, they are going to laugh, expressing their teeth. And they are going to prove that we are free from material torture. They are Mayavadi. So this way actually they are going to put themselves in more and more Maya. But anyway, the case of Naraji Maharaj, you see, about bonded soul, if you think this way, satsang was perfect. Satsang was really perfect. So, now consciousness growing, even satsanga was done such a way, exclusive way, that after those sadhu, they gone, Naraji Maharaj continuously thinking about that thing. Follow. Continuously thinking about thing, about the sadhu sangha. The sadhu sangha gone. So, in the life of a disciple, genuine disciple, Gurudev can give darshan inside heart all the time. That is called genuine bhakta. Genuine bhakta. So, day by day, Naraji Maharaj is going to express his tremendous desire for bhakti. This way, a trying, and after that, when going to leave body, then fraction of second you could get darshan of Bhagavan, and after that, Bhagavan speaking that this life, only one fraction of second I was bound to give you darshan, so that you can feel inspiration. To give you inspiration, actually, those people, they have some smell of kama, this, that, not clean. You know. And actually it is written that perfect guru, sadguru, under the guidance of sadguru, if you are doing, then okay. If not, then it is written that this, your bhajan is not, you know, there is some stain, some smell. So you cannot, you know, come out successful this life. After that, Bhagavan, it is written there, about Naraji Maharaj, it is written. Prajujyamane mayi tvam sudhyam bhagavatim tanum arabd karma nirvana napatat panch bhautikaha. Prajujyamane, it is written. That means, from Piti Sandarbha we'll have to discuss how it is possible when a jivatma becomes successful, then how Bhagavan going to arrange his nitya siddha. Actually, nitya siddha deho means parsad deho. If we say parsad deho can fall down, is useless. We cannot speak this way, that parsad deho can fall down. Parsad deho eternally present. Sarupete sabar hai golakete siti. We can discuss this point. You can see is the sarup when you can discover your sarup. In that case, how we can get seva there in Itarlanta, that I can discuss in detail. Prajujyamane mahi. So, prajujyamane mahi sudhyam bhagavatim tanum. Bhagavan going to allow one bishuddho tanu. Arab, you know, prajujyamane when going to allow me. Here, awarded means manifested. Somebody can say, Maharaj, prajujyamane mahi tvam sudhyam bhagavatim tanum. And Vishwanath Chakur speaking, it is awarded. Awarded means manifested. In pursuance of Siddhanta presented by our Gauriya Acharyas in the previous chapter, you know, the aim is that Jivatma can do bhajan perfectly. After that, when going to get Siddhi perfect, I mean Vastu Siddhi, then the Jiva Sarup with regard to its being awarded or manifested. This means when Sarupa express, in that case he can discover prajujyamane mean actually awarded means manifested. Otherwise it is wrong Siddhanta, then every time all Jivatma can, you know. This way we can discuss this point tomorrow. So eternally established in heart, Nitya Siddha Bhav, Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhugabu Noi, eternally present inside heart, only our bhajan can help express it, Nitya Siddha Svabhavasya Prakatyam Hidi Saddhata. Nitya Siddha Svabhavasya Prakatyam Hidi Saddhata. So eternally established inside heart. Of inside the hearts of living entities, pure love for Krishna is eternally established inside the hearts of the living entities. It is not something to be, you know, it is not something to be gained from another sources, from outside, not that. When the heart is purified by Savan Kirtan, everything as Chaitanya Pranarjan Mahaprabhu speaking, by hearing Harikatha Kirtan and chanting, this love naturally awakens from inside. You can remember another sloka, long time before I was discussing. Yatha yatha atma parimijyate asau matpunna gatha sabano vidhanai tatha tatha us. You know, this sloka you can remember from Bhagavatam. Yatha yatha atma parimijyate asau matpunna gatha sabano vidhanai tatha tatha pashyati vastu suksham chakshusaiva anjana samprajuktam. Yatha yatha atma parimijyate asau. The more you go on hearing Harikatha sincerely, then the more you can clean your heart. The more you can go on hearing Harikatha and do Kirtan, you can clean your heart, very, very clean, you can clean. Yatha yatha atma parimijyate asau matpunna gatha savana vidhani. What? Not mayavat. Bhagavan himself speaking, all about my glories. You will have to hear my past times and glories. Yatha yatha atma parimijyate asau matpunna gatha. Mat, Bhagavan speaking, about me, Supreme Divinity, about my leelas, kirtan you will have to do and hear. Yatha yatha atma parimijyate asau matpunna gatha savano vidhani. The more you can do, the more you can clean your heart, you can grow fine darshan power. like the example given, Anjana Samprayuktam, just like Anjana Samprayuktam. Anjana means black. In childhood, usually our mother, they used to apply black in our eyes, so that we can grow the power of our sight, darshan kamata. Similarly, this example given, yatha yathatma parimijyate asu matpunna gatha savano vidhanai tatha tatha pashyati vastu sukshmam. The more you can clean, the more you can get the power to see fine things. Fine means spiritual things. Even in the field of spiritual thing, there is so many fine bhava. So you can, according to your bhajan, you can get power to see vastu sukshmam. So, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spoke the following verse to Sanatan Gosai. This first verse is also found in Rasamrita Sindhu also, you can find. Ishte Sarasiki Ragaha Paramavishchata Bhavet. Ishte Sarasiki Ragaha Paramavishchata Bhavet. Tanmaiya Bhavet Bhakti Svato Ragat Mikoditaha. When one becomes attached to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, when one, like Naraji, attraction, growing attraction, when one becomes attached to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, about the Jivatma, her natural inclination to love is fully absorbed in her thoughts. Follow. When one becomes attached to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, her natural inclination to love is fully absorbed in the thoughts of the Lord. That is actually transcendental attachment. And all you have material experience about material attachment. Attachment from money, position, everything. You know, you have practical experience. But try to understand, when one becomes attached to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, her natural inclination to love is fully absorbed in thoughts of the Supreme Lord. That is actually called transcendental attachment. And when this transcendental attachment increasing, why Naraji Maharaj was successful? Why this slok was spoken? Prajujyamane mahi tvam bhagavatin tunu, you know, this body is going to throw. After this, when come out successful, then Bhagavan going to give him, award. Awarded means manifested. His Nitya Siddha Deho may get manifested. So, that is called actually, here we find transcendental attachment. And devotional service according to that attachment, and devotional service according to that attachment is called Ragatvika. First of all, you can grow attachment, and that attachment can go on increasing extreme point, as is called transcendental attachment. And devotional service according to that attachment, the kind of attachment you are receiving, is called ragatmika or spontaneous devotional service. There is some special jobs. In case of all Jivatma, it is possible. In case of all Jivatma, it is possible 100%. 100% is possible. Because in Vaikuntha Jagat, in Priti Sandarbha, Jiva Goswami was writing, after having been awarded the body of an eternal associate Narad's, Naraji Maharaj's Panchabhautik, the material body made up of five material elements, was dissolved, follow. After having been awarded means manifested, I already told. The body of an eternal associate was given, Prajujyamane. Naraji Maharaja's Panchabhautik, his body made out of five material elements, was dissolved. In Srimad Bhagavad-gita Mahapuran, in the commentary of Srila Jiva Goswami and other acharyas have given the explanation of the sloka that I can discuss tomorrow. Also, today I like to touch one point. Why it is written Golokete Savar Hai Sarupete Savar Hai Golokete Siti? By Sarup, everybody, their existence there in Golok. Also, I was giving answer that when somebody getting Siddhi, how it is possible that now he is going to enter into Siddha Jagat, how eternity can fulfill, that discussion although I have done last Harikatha, how Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving answer. If situation demand, tomorrow also I can demand. Automatically. Because eternally Sarupa Jiva there, they forget, but when they discover, the eternity gets satisfied, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. So this way, and also another point, very important, that this sloka, the Vaikunthasya Bhagavato Jyotirmaya Bhutaha, etc., this sloka, I can discuss tomorrow. In Vaikuntha Jagat, there are infinite spiritual forms which are all Jyotirmaya. Yeah. All Jatir Amsa Bhuta forms which have, you know, emanated from the effulgence of the form of the Supreme Lord. Jiva Goswami speaking. There are countless, you know, in Vaikuntha Jagat, there are infinite spiritual forms, Murti. When a devotee becomes liberated, then the Lord makes that soul one with one of those unlimited forms already resting there. In Vaikuntha Jagat, there is nothing which is not Chinmay, all Chinmay. But still, by the help of that body, what Bhagavan going to grant many manifested, they can start serving. They can discover, manifest it. Unlimited. So, we know that, see, Jiva Goswami Pad has written in Priti Sandarbha in relation to the Salakka Mukti, there are countless infinite spiritual bodies or associates in Vaikuntha Jagat. His remarkable word, remarkable Siddhanta, that have manifested from the effulgence of Bhagavan. Those spiritual bodies are waiting to be accepted by the living entities who have become perfect by sadhana bhajan. I can discuss, don't be in confusion. I know I am doing half discussion, so it can increase your confusion. So I like to discuss more in detail tomorrow about this and how you are going to enter into eternal world, Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhava also. I already discussed, but still, tomorrow I can discuss about this special point, how it is possible. That in Vaikuntha Jagat there is nothing material, all Chinmaya. Hare Maharaj, you are this material body. If you are going to start argument, your material body, Follow, try to understand. This your material body, you have no idea how countless jivas living inside your body. Your Chidatma is there, na? And all living souls are there. All bacteria and this, they all there, living inside your body. So, inside your body, countless jivas. So, try to understand this point. When one jivatma going to enter into eternal jagat, in that case, how it is possible that Jiva Goswami is speaking, there is some spiritual bodies waiting. When they are going to, they can only discover it. Bhagavan can arrange each one of them with each one of each body. They are not achetan. They are not. There is nothing allowed in a prakriti jagat, which is, you know, material thing is not allowed. But still, they are like decoration. They are waiting just like decoration. They are chidvastu. In Vaikuntha jagat, even dust particle, river, everything chinmay. Briksha, all chinmay. Similarly, those, you know, spiritual bodies coming, emanating from the body effulgence of Supreme Lord is also in the form of some decoration there. Each jivatma, when going to come out successful, Bhagavan can arrange each body waiting there for one jivatma. I can explain very scientifically tomorrow. Today not possible to discuss all in details. Tomorrow I can discuss, I can show how it is possible. Then you can get the answer of this, you know, Siddhanta Vichar. Golokete Sabar Hai, Sarupete Sabar Hai, Golokete Siti. By Sarup, everybody there already in Golokdham. Follow. I can discuss about this point. So today, time is over. I cannot discuss, you know, this point. So, you see, Andham tamaha pravishanti je avidyam upasate tato bhuyo evote tamo ja uvidyam upasate. Those who are not doing bhakti, for them only they can go to hell. Tama, agyan, in darkness they can go, nowhere else. They can go to darkness. Day by day they can go to darkness. So this way you have to, you know, Siddhanta is pakka, Siddhanta perfect. That when you are going to do any jivatma, when they are going to do bhakti unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan, then all you can come out successful. Yatha tarar mul nise cha neno tippantita skanda bhujopu sakha pranupaharas cha jatendriyanam tathaiva sarva arham achyutecha. All, if you are going to do Krishna bhakti, all your duty, all your responsibility, anything, all done, all complete. You need not play your head about that. So yatha tararamul nisechanena tippanti taskanda bhujo pusaka pranopaharascha yathendriyanam tathaiva sarva arahananam achyutejya vanchakalpaturusike pasindu bhavacha patitanam pavana bhavishnabhyo namah.